Welcome to the intro to Newton's laws of motion. We've already discussed acceleration and how an object's change in speed or direction will affect its motion. So today our focus really is, what is this motion and what kind of forces need to be present to cause that change in motion? Our two essential questions then are, what is force? So we'll go through a bunch of examples here. And then, how does each of those forces impact the motion of an object? And as we talk about how those forces impact the motion, we'll go over a couple key words such as balanced and unbalanced forces, and also net force. And we'll use this little symbol called sigma to represent net force. So what we need to know is a force is either a push or a pull on an object. Okay, now sometimes those forces are easy to see when the force is being applied, when someone is actually physically pushing a box or pulling a wagon. However, sometimes it's not quite as obvious, it's not as noticeable, such as a friction force, where a car would drive over a road, you wouldn't necessarily realize the friction between the road and the tires. Now, this contact force is a force that occurs when it comes in contact with an object, and friction force is a common one of those contact forces. A friction force is a force exerted by a surface as an object moves over it, or that sometimes attempts to move over it. So for example, here we've got the air hockey table, right? And as these guys try to play air hockey without turning it on, they're really struggling to move the puck because of the friction between the puck here and the rink table. Okay, but once they flip that switch on, the air pocket is between the puck and the rink, so the friction force is much lower, causing it to be much easier to bump that puck around. Now, friction force also is in several different locations. A common example would be like a tire, okay, like a car tire, bike tire, skateboard tire, between the tire here and the road. That would be a friction force. Another contact force here is the tension force, a force that we see either on a rope, a string, or a cable. As we can see here, this rope is pulled nice and tight from both directions. That increases the tension force. We could see it with a tightrope walker, with a hammock. Okay, any of those examples would be the rope or the string pulled tightly. Air resistance is another contact force. This is also a frictional force, but instead of happening with the surface, now it's happening as an object falls through the air or moves through the air. So here an example we have our skydiver. Right, as he falls through the air, all these little air molecules here are bombarding against his body, and therefore he has air resistance, friction with the air molecules around him. Our next force is normal force, and this is a force that is exerted as a support force. And it's a support force coming from an object in contact with another stable object. So here we see a book sitting on your desk, just like most of you have your notebook or your binder sitting on your desk at all times. We know, of course, gravity is working on this force, on your book, keeping it at rest at the table here. So here's my gravity force. Okay, but we know that this can't be the only force acting on the book, because if it were, the book would be crashing down through your desk. So there has to be an equal and opposite force keeping this binder here in place. And that's where the normal force comes in.
Okay, the normal force is coming from the stable object, so in this case, the table. We call this normal because it's always around, right? It's there to counteract that gravitational force so things stay balanced. We see another example of normal force here. The bird, of course, gravity is keeping it on the branch, but the branch is then pushing back with a normal force to the bird.
An applied force is simply a force that is applied to an object. Okay, so there's all kinds of applied forces when a person is pushing something, pulling something, like a hammer, hammering on a nail would be an applied force. When an object is being subjected to a force that is applied directly to it, would be an applied force. A spring force is occurring when a spring is either fully compressed or stretched. Okay, so here of course we just have a spring, okay, but several examples would be like a trampoline, a bungee jump, when you sit on a couch, right? All of those would be examples where a spring is present and a force is then exerted on the spring by either compressing it or totally stretching it out. Now, not all forces are contact forces. We do have a few action at a distance forces where a push or a pull still occurs due to that force, but no contact is required. And gravitational force is really going to be the one that we're going to focus on here, okay? All objects, of course, here on Earth have a gravitational force on them. So we'll make sure that we include that gravity force downward with every example that we do. Electrical force, magnetic force, those are also examples. But again, we'll focus mostly on gravity. So overall, all of those forces can cause one thing. They can cause an object to, of course, change motion. And from our previous discussions, we know that a change in motion equals a change in speed or a change in direction.